Namaste fam, Wolfcore here. So, today, I wanted to make a video addressing a specific comment, or a couple of comments that I got very recently from a viewer named Wynn Abad. So Wynn had a really good question for me. Basically, how do you get girls if you're shy? And this is a really good question, and it's something that I've spent a lot of my life pondering. I have social anxiety, if you don't know, and I'm very shy. I'm also introverted. And I wanted to just, you know, I've been thinking about it. I've been wanting to respond to this comment since I got it. And every time I started to get into it mentally, I was like, there is just way too much to unpack here. I can't do this just typing out. Well, I could, but I would end up sending the poor guy a freaking novel. So I figured I'd just make a video. So this is just going to be me going into a little bit of my history with relationships and some advice on how to get into a relationship whilst you're shy. So to give you a frame of reference where I'm coming from, I have spent the past 15 years of my life, I'm 28 now, and I started dating when I was 13. I also lost my virginity when I was 13, fun fact. And I have spent the past 15 years of my life probably in about 10 meaningful relationships, ranging anywhere from 4 months to 2 years. So I do have a good amount of experience. My closest friends have a nickname for me. They call me Player. I've never got that. I don't think of myself as a player whatsoever, like not even a little bit. I'm as I said, I'm super shy. I've never in my life been comfortable approaching women or men or anything. Like, I'm super introverted. But somehow I seem to find myself in these relationships. So how did I get there? Well, the first way I got there, I guess you could say, is, I mean, this hasn't been true my whole life, but in more recent years, I have just kind of stopped looking. You know, when you're really desperate to be with somebody, partially it's gonna mean that you're probably pretty codependent, which is just unhealthy, and you're gonna come across as desperate. Like, oh, I need somebody so bad to complete me. It's just like, you gotta 86 that whole attitude, that whole idea. Just really, really just focus on being with yourself. Focus on being happy alone. And that is not an easy pill for a lot of people to swallow. It took me quite a few years of my life to get that down. I mean, when I first started dating when I was 13, I was so needy, so clingy, so codependent. It was disgusting. And now I am 100% comfortable on my own. I actually prefer being single at this point in my life. Kind of doing that MGTOW thing right now, but that's a whole nother topic that I won't get into. But yeah, you just don't be needy. Don't be obsessed with the idea of being in a relationship. If you do feel that way, I get it, but really, really try to internalize this idea of just being happy with yourself, focusing on your own shit, and eventually somebody's gonna come into your life. That's just part of being in human society. Like, people come and go throughout your life, and some of them are gonna be the right sexual preference for you, and some of them are gonna find you attractive, and you're gonna find some of them attractive, and eventually things are just gonna happen. That's just what happens. So, you know, be patient, focus on doing what makes you happy, and being happy on your own. So if first of all is learn to be happy on your own, second of all would have to be learn to take care of yourself. And let's just start with physically, because let's face it, humans are kind of shallow creatures. We are attracted to each other physically. You tend to go for people that you like their face most of all, and then secondly, people whose bodies you like most of all. That's gonna be one of the main contributing factors in whether or not you're finding yourself with partners that you like. So with that in mind, every day of your life, practice mindfulness, practice discipline in being the best you that you can, starting with physically. So that's gonna be watching what you eat, eating healthy stuff and an appropriate amount of it. Not too little so that you're, you know, unhealthy and sickly, and not too much so that you're, you know, overweight or obese. It's just gonna be, think about what you're eating, what you're putting into your body, and you know, try and make that as healthy as possible. That can be tough if you're young and your parents don't buy healthy options naturally or on their own. But you know, you could talk to them about it, be like, hey, you know, I wanna start being healthier. I wanna start taking care of myself a little better. Can we, you know, get some stuff out of the produce section. And it takes a lot of discipline to learn to eat healthy. It's something that I'm still working on, and it's something that I'm gonna work on until the day that I die. But it's a really good way to build discipline, to be healthier, to feel healthier. And so focus on what you eat and how much you eat. Make it as healthy as possible. And do lots of internet research. Always be researching and trying to learn what's gonna make you feel like the healthiest you and look like the best you. Also, on that same vein of physical, you know, wash your face, you know, get some face wash, clean out those pores, you know, make that skin look as good as possible. Get haircuts if you can, you know, find a haircut that works for you. Don't just buzz it off like I used to do in my early 20s. Like, find a nice haircut that works for you and try and get haircuts regularly. Do anything that you can to try and just kind of make all of this as attractive as possible. Like, not to the point that it's unhealthy, but to the point where, you know, it's healthy and you've got that nice intersection of, like, you're doing what's right for you and what makes you look the best. There's also fashion, you know? For example, don't go out and max out your credit cards trying to, you know, up your fashion game. But when you do have to go shopping for stuff, take time with it. You know, especially if you're a straight guy, you know, you're not encouraged to do this. You're encouraged to just kind of like get whatever's there, whatever's cheap, whatever's durable, whatever's rugged, you know, blah, blah, blah. No, like, take some time, find some shit that makes you look good, that makes you feel confident, that makes your eyes pop, you know, whatever it is, you know, take time with fashion. Just make sure you're maximizing all of this so that you can attract a mate. All right, number one, learn to be happy on your own. Number two, take care of that bod, fam. And number three, confidence. Guys, especially for you guys, this whole video isn't totally applicable to the ladies out there. This is more so for the guys. Confidence, you have to be confident to attract a partner 90% of the time. That's just, I don't mean to speak for women here, but women tend to go crazy for confidence. If you can even fake confidence, like if you go to a party and act like a wallflower, nobody's gonna talk to you. If you go to a party and you just like pretend to be confident, people will be talking to you. And some of those people will be girls, and some of those girls will be attractive and single. So boom, confidence, like fake it until you make it. Fake confidence until you learn to actually be confident. But let's talk about actually learning to become confident. You can start faking confidence at any time, and that's a great skill to kind of have in your back pocket when you're not feeling confident. You can just kind of like, whoop, put on that confidence mask and be like, hey, what's up, baby? But if you want to actually become confident, do the things that I've already been talking about. Number one is, you know, take care of yourself. When you feel good, you're going to be more confident naturally. You're going to get confidence points from that. And that's, you know, discipline over the course of a lifetime. But if you want to take a more active approach to becoming more confident, I would say find something that you want to do, something that's worth doing, and really, really hone that skill. And this could be anything from sports to something professional, like being an electrician, or learning to make YouTube videos, just to name some examples from my own life, and practice it and become good at it, like really good at it for years and years. Just practice this thing, and you'll have eventually, you know, after a few months, you'll develop this sort of just confidence in the back of your mind, knowing that you have these skills, something that, you know, they're like little badges, invisible badges that you're wearing, little medals that you've earned through like hard work and discipline. And it could be anything, but just find things that are worth doing and do them over and over and over again until you get really good at them. And especially if you can get good at them enough to have something that you can show to other people, whether that be by posting videos of you doing this thing on Instagram, or, you know, it's your work so you can talk about it, or it's jogging and you've become a good avid runner and you could invite, you know, maybe this cute athletic girl that you like out on a jog, you know. So that's, just do that. Just find something that's worth doing and pursue that. It's so important. You gotta do it, fam. I know it's hard, but I believe in you. Okay, fam, let's review. We've got learn to be happy on your own. We've got take care of that bod, fam. And we've got Confidence, boo, get some. It's hard. All these things are hard and they take discipline, but there's never a bad time in your life, no matter how young you are, to start learning discipline. Discipline is so important, and it's going to be one of the most essential skills to have as you become an adult and for the rest of your life. So I'd say even step four is cultivate that discipline. But guys, that has been my video. I hope if this even helps one person in their life or in their romantic endeavors, that would be super awesome and that would make me super happy. If there are any ladies watching this video, please leave some comments down below. I will make sure to put big old hearts on them so that the guys can read them. If you have any advice for the guys as to, you know, how to attract one of your lovely selves, that would be great. I know the guys would love to go down and read your comments. And please just leave any comments you have at all, any other advice. And yeah, smash that like button while you're at it. I would love that. And subscribe if you're new here. I hope this helped. Loved your faces. Beard heart. Bye-bye.